people of God was protected. The people of God was secure. Why? Because the blood is on the door. He says, when I see the blood, when I see the blood, I will pass. So this is why we get what? Pass. Pass. So we, so amen. So we see what? We see what? The Lamb, and we see what? Sacrifice. The Lamb and sacrifice. Yes, remember, the Lamb is pointing to Jesus. Amen? It is pointing to Jesus. So what they are doing here, it was a foreshadow of what Jesus Christ, when he came, is going to do. Let me pray. I'm going to pray. Then we will walk from there. Old Testament, New Testament. Old Testament, New Testament. Old Testament, New Testament. To you, Lord. To you, Lord. Amen. And Paul prayed for the church of Ephesus, right? In Ephesians chapter 1. What Paul prayed? What was Paul prayed? That the eyes of their understanding will be enlightened. That they will know. That they will know. That they will, that they will know the hope of who he's calling and the richness of who his inheritance. Where is in you? Where is in you? So what that means? That means that you are Christ's inheritance. You are Christ's inheritance. You gotta know it. Amen. I'm Christ's inheritance. Hallelujah. Now,
the Lamb, which was in Exodus 12, 7, amen, and we read the 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 19, right, amen, and it basically, it break it down for us. It gave us a better understanding of what it was doing back in Exodus. Amen. Now, let's go to Leviticus 17. Leviticus chapter 17 and verse 14. Leviticus 17 and verse 14. Leviticus 17 and verse 14. Amen. Leviticus 17 and verse 14. Hallelujah. And read.
Verse 14. For it is the life of all flesh.
So it is the life of all flesh as well. Read.
The blood of it is the life thereof.
Amen. So the life of all flesh is what? The blood. The life of all flesh is the what? The blood. Somebody say the blood.
The blood.
Say the blood.
The blood.
Oh God. Say the blood.
The blood.
Good Lord, I can't hear some of y'all in, y'all saying it like y'all not even sure.
The blood.
The blood. I guarantee when I get you teaching this, you will say it with conviction. You will share it knowing and understanding that the blood still got power today.
Amen. Thank you for the blood.
Glory be to God. The life of all flesh is in the blood. The life of the physical man or woman is in the blood.
Amen.
The blood comes out, the life comes out.
Amen.
Because the life of all flesh is in the blood. Amen. So any doubts, that's why. When a person maybe get caught, they can, and it really is a serious cut, they can bleed to death. Because the life of the flesh is in the blood. Not the life of the spirit. It's a different. Not the light of your, see, your spirit doesn't need a body. Your spirit is eternal life in you.
Amen.
I say, the spirit of man is eternal life in you. So that's why your spirit can't die. Your body die. But your spirit can never die. Because why? It's eternal. How do I know? It comes out of God.
Amen.
And anything that comes out of God cannot die.
Live forever.
Amen.
Amen. Glory be to God. Understand the Passover. That the devil, amen. Say the devil. Say, I'm gonna knock out the devil tonight with the blood. Yes, sir. So I'm gonna knock him out with the blood. Some of y'all need to knock him out with the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Knock him out with the blood of Jesus tonight. Amen. So when we get through, we're going to knock him out and slay out those demons, those lying spirits. Glory be to God with the blood of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. See, most church don't talk about the blood no more. They don't talk about the blood of Jesus no more. It's like the blood lose its power. How could the blood of God lose power?
The power.
Oh, Jesus, you better stop bleeding some blood.
Yes.
Amen. I remember a few years ago I preached a sermon justified by the blood. Amen. And I say as well, in the beginning of the sermon, I said that I will not plead guilty. Because if I plead guilty, I will be condemned.
Amen.
And I will not plead not guilty. Because if I plead not guilty, I'll be found a liar. So I'm going to plead the blood.
The blood of
Jesus. Hallelujah. See, I'm going to plead the blood of Jesus. Because if you plead guilty, you'll be condemned. If you plead not guilty, you'll become a liar.
Amen.
But when you plead the blood.
The blood of Jesus.
Hallelujah. This is what we need to plead. Amen. Plead the blood. Glory be to God. Plead the blood of Jesus. Amen. I'm telling you, something to move in this place tonight. I'm telling the Holy Ghost to move in this house.
Amen.
Tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. I came on a rise. Amen. To release. At least to release a level of anointing in this house.
Yes.
I'm telling you, amen. God sent me tonight to release a level of anointing in this house. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. You ain't gonna be still. I'm telling you, you're gonna be still and let the devil walk over you.
No.
When Jesus Christ has already given you victory over the enemy. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Don't sit down and let the devil sit on you. Amen. Fight back with the blood. Yes, sir. Restrict him with the blood. Amen. Block him with the blood. Glory be to God. Amen. Now, everything that happens in the Old Testament is a past shadow of the New Testament. Let me say it again. The Old Testament is the New Testament concealed. The Old Testament is the New Testament concealed. The New Testament is the Old Testament revealed. So that's why Moses, Joshua, David, they could not locate Jesus. Because Jesus was concealed. Even though he was in the Old Testament. But his name, Jesus, was not yet revealed. Amen. In the teaching on it, I can find Jesus in Genesis, Exodus, Numbers, Deuteronomy. Walk straight to the book. Hallelujah. Now, let's go to the book of Acts, New Testament, Acts chapter 15, verse 28 and 29. Acts chapter 15, verse 28 and 29. Amen. Now we establishing what? Understanding. We establishing understanding. Amen. Understanding what? The meaning of the what? Passover, right? You want to understand the Passover. You just don't want to celebrate something that you don't know. Amen? What I say, the more you understand, the more liberated you become. Do you know when you understand, your faith grows to another level. That's why the enemy doesn't want us to understand, because when we understand, our faith moves to another level. Because now we can see and we can hope. In the book of Acts, the 15th chapter, the 28 and 29 verse, and it read.
Verse
28
reads.
Verse 28.
Verse 28 reads.
Uh-huh. It
seemed good to the Holy Ghost.
Uh-huh.
And to us to lay upon you no greater burden than these necessary things.
Okay.
29. That ye abstain from meats offered to idols.
Uh-huh.
See,
to us, this is why, if I say I'm not going to eat from a certain place, and if I find out that they really do offer this meat to the false god, it's scripture. You're supposed to eat it. I don't care how much prayer you pray.
Huh?
It's New Testament. Hallelujah. Because why? That meat has been offered up to idols. Read.
And from things sprinkled, and from fornication.